we're broke, we're getting deeper in debt by the minute, and we're wasting this money overseas, it's not doing us any good, and it's time to come home. We should be able to rally the country behind this. But you know, the other candidates on our side, they're not advocating, they're taking a position and saying that Obama is not doing enough, he needs to fight even more war. That attitude is shifting. I've been talking about the war issue for a long time, as long as I've been in Congress. I remember the first talk I gave on the House floor about Iraq. It was in 1998, you know, about 5 years before they invaded it. But it is this attitude that we're supposed to be the policemen of the world, we're supposed to occupy countries and get involved and go into nation building. That is not in the Constitution. It spends a lot of money and it doesn't help us in national defense. It actually makes us less defensible because we don't ever want to equate military spending with defense spending. Military spending sometimes is a strong negative for defense. But because of our foreign policy, just think of what's happened this last couple weeks, you know. First we have the abuse of corpses by our military, and then people getting shot up, and all the tragedies. That's even small compared to how much collateral damage there is, you know. And then we have to look at it maybe from their viewpoint. The other, not too many weeks ago, we had a debate, and I suggested, why don't we consider a foreign policy where we think about the golden rule? How would we like to do it? Of course, the response that night wasn't quite the same as your response. The golden rule, you know. And it's not like one religion has a monopoly over the golden rule. All the great religions, you know, preach the golden rule, trying to treat other people as you would be treated. That's the way individual liberty should be, that's the way economic liberty should be, but certainly overseas, this is the way it should be. Can you imagine? Is the established policy by the president of assassinations of American citizens. This is not in the Constitution. It's not what made America great. And those kind of laws cannot stay on the books. We have secret prisons. We now have a law passed, Congress passed, it came to the president. The president signed on January 1st. The National Defense Authorization Act. By the military. So there's no more posse comitatus. You don't have to be charged. You don't get a trial. And one senator said, if they ask for a lawyer, tell them they don't get one. And people say, well, they haven't touched me or my neighbor, but precedent is very important. And to codify these kind of things is very, very dangerous. And I think the American people haven't heard about that. The crowds like this, you have heard about it, and I think that is great that you're aware of it, but we still have a long way to go. president, I will not go to war ever without a declared war. And these laws have become laws because the president broke an executive order. Legislate, maybe for a few rare moments, they can use it for direction of proper executive function. But if he passed laws, as they have been doing, I believe a constitutional president can use an executive order to repeal those laws.
Say, oh, that sounds terrible. I'm
of you to argue states' rights. You know, that's pretty old-fashioned. But what about states that pass laws that allow sick people to use marijuana?
Yes, sir!
I should know from the other side of the aisle that might call themselves liberals say, oh, under those circumstances, let's have states' rights. Let the states allow people to use marijuana for medical reasons if they want to.